evening I'm making a fabulous basil pesto. There's been recent reports in relation to the high salt content in shop-bought basil pesto. So I just decided it's so simple to make, I'd show you how to make one yourself. Now, there's not really an ingredient list for this. There's more so a series of products that must be put in to have it really good. So what I've got here is I've just got a large handful of fresh basil, to which I'm adding in about 1 dessert spoonful of grated Parmesan cheese. And use a really nice, good quality Parmesan for that. I'm also adding in 1 dessert spoonful of pine nuts. Now you can have these either toasted or untoasted. I like the untoasted version because I think if they're toasted, it can be very intensely nutty, but that's your flavour far straight ahead. And then I'm going to add in 3 cloves of garlic in there as well. Also, an ingredient that I'm putting in that's not in every pesto is some lemon juice. I'm going to add in the juice of about 1/2 a lemon, and I'm just using the sieve there just to catch any unnecessary pips from that. The purpose of adding the lemon is twofold. The first thing it does is it just extracts out all of that lovely, fabulous chlorophyll plant pigment that's found in the basil, so you end up with a very resplendent green coloured pesto. And also what it does is it acts as a preservative, so it will keep that lovely green colour over the series of a number of days as it ages in the fridge. So that's almost it. I'm going to add in about 100 millilitres there, which is 3.5 fluid ounces of oil. You can use olive oil, or I'm actually using a lovely rapeseed oil, a local rapeseed oil. So I'm going to do that. Now again, you can adjust the oil quantity depending on kind of how thick or how thin you want your pesto and what it is you're going to use it for. Transfer that then to a food processor, or I'm actually just using the immersion stick blender, and I'm literally just going to blitz this just for a second or two. And I'm going to make a fairly thick pesto because I'm kind of suggesting that you could use this maybe as a kind of little dip for some crudités or some tortilla crisps, or of course if you're making a lovely basil pesto pasta, you can kind of just cook your pasta and then maybe just toss it in a bit of basil pesto, tear in maybe some parma ham, add in some roasted vegetables, add in a little bit of cooked chicken, and you're all good. So just look at that, fabulous, fabulous colour, and I'm just going to transfer this out here to my serving bowl. And just see that lovely consistency. Now, if basil isn't your fancy, you could maybe use some sun-dried tomatoes instead to make a lovely sun-dried tomato pesto. But that's absolutely fabulous. And as I said, crudités, you can mix it into some mayonnaise and use it as a kind of a dressing for salads or sandwiches or into lovely pasta dishes. You know, cook up a few bits of veg on the pan, cook up some parma ham, maybe some lovely Italian pancetta or that Spanish sausage chorizo, and pop that in. Parmesan cheese on the top. Fabulous.